Hi students, welcome back. Let's continue with this our web technology subject. In the previous video, I explained about the dynamic HTML. Now let's see the XML. What is an XML? XML stands for Extensible Markup Language. So this X we are taking, Extensible Markup Language. It is just like a HTML and was designed to describe the data. So HTML is whatever you are going to be written on the page, that is going to be displayed on the screen. It's just a static thing. HTML is a static, whatever you are writing that will be displayed on the screen. But whereas XML, it's just like a HTML, but it was designed to describe the data. Whatever the data that you are using, that is going to be described. Let's see. XML tags are not predefined. You must define your own tags. So here, whatever the tags that we are using for the XML, those are not predefined. You must define your own tags. That's the main fetching in this XML documents. The XML uses a document type definition, that is a DTD, document type definition, or an XML schema to describe the data. I said, what's the use of the XML? The XML is going to design, it is designed to describe the data. How it is going to describe the data? By using the document type definition or a schema, XML schema, which is used to describe the data. XML with a document type definition or XML schema is designed to be a self-descriptive. These two are DTD and the XML schema is designed to be a self-descriptive. XML is a cross-platform software and hardware independent tool for transmitting the information. Now let's see what are the different uses of the XML. Why we are using the XML? What are the usage? Okay, and what is the usage of this XML? XML can work behind the scene to simplify the creation of HTML document for large websites. So this XML is work behind the scene. Whatever the HTML document you are able to see, this XML is supporting this HTML document and it works behind the scene to simplify. Why we are using that XML? To simplify the creation of HTML document for large websites. Whenever the large websites are you creating, you have to create so many pages. So to simplify that creation of HTML documents, we are using this XML. XML can be used to exchange the information between organization and systems. So this is also another use. XML can be used for offloading and reloading of database. Okay. So the XML can be used for the offloading and reloading of database. It can be used to store and arrange the data. So the another usage of XML is it is used to store and arrange the data which customize your data handling needs. So based on your handling needs, you can use it to store and arrange the data wherever you want by using this XML. XML can easily be merged with the style sheets to create almost any desired output. So if you want, you can merge these XMLs with style sheets, the cascading style sheets, so which are going to create almost any desired output. So let's see the syntax of this XML. So this is the declaration first. This is a version that we are using, XML question mark. You have to use the small letters. Okay, it's a case sensitive. Remember this, small letters you need to be used. XML version is equal to 1.0. Okay, 1.0, and here this is the contact information that I want to be print on the screen. The contact information, this is one tag, and the name are given in between the tags, and the company, it's a tag in between. I am writing the company name and the phone number, and the contact information will be closed. This is a basic syntax of this XML. So the starting step, this is an important for declaring the tags, whatever the tags that you are using. I already said we can create our own. You must define your own tags. So that's why I'm defining my own tags. Contact information, name, company, phone number, my own tags. Okay, whenever I declared XML version, so I can create my own tags. That's the main use of this XML. So here you can observe there are two kinds of information is present. In this program, you can observe two kinds of information is there. One is markup link. So this is a markup link. If you observe this, This is a markup link, contact information. Okay, and text or a character, whatever the message that you have written in between these markup language, that you call it as a text or a characters. So here two kinds of information is present in XML document. One is a markup like contact information, and the text or a character like education for you and the contact number. Okay, so let's see the syntax rules that can write different types of markup and text in an XML document. So the syntax rules is applies to the XML declaration, references, tag and add elements, different tags and elements, and the attributes that we are using, and different text that we are applying in between the tags. Okay, so we will see about the XML declaration in the next video. Thank you.